Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. For many decades, standard cosmology has proposed a universe that is disconnected, incoherent, chaotic, strange, and literally dark. In this cosmology, around 96% of the universe is invisible and undetectable, composed of the mysterious entities dark matter and dark energy. In the early 20th century, some noted astronomers proposed the concept of dark matter as a possible solution to the anomalous stellar rotation profiles in galaxies. The mystery was, why do Newtonian dynamics fail to explain the impossibly high velocities of rotation of the outer stars in galaxies? Later scientists using galaxy rotation curves also proposed the apparent need for many times more dark matter than visible mass. For the last 85 years, scientists on Earth have hypothesized many different types of dark matter, and the search continues in earnest today, with astronomical sums invested in the technological quest to prove dark matter's existence. Yet rather than finding any confirmation of dark matter, space scientists have been left empty-handed, with only an ever-growing list of unresolved puzzles. One such new puzzle completely confounds all theoretical predictions for the standard lambda-cold dark matter model. A team of scientists studying the elliptical galaxy Centaurus A has made the astonishing discovery that the galaxy is orbited by a number of dwarf satellites arranged in a, quote, narrow disk. This kind of coherent, non-random arrangement of host galaxies and their satellites is completely unexpected in standard cosmology. As noted in a recent phys.org report, under the lambda cold dark matter model, smaller systems of stars should be more or less randomly scattered around their anchoring galaxies and should move in all directions. To understand just how problematic this discovery is for standard cosmology, these models and simulations have predicted that only 0.5% of nearby satellite galaxy systems should exhibit this kind of pattern. However, to astronomers' complete bafflement, 14 of the 16 Centaurus A satellites display this pattern of common rotation along the main galaxy's plane. And this is not the first instance when scientists have documented satellite dwarf galaxies co-rotating in a, quote, preferentially oriented alignment around a central galactic mass, producing a, quote, vast polar structure. As noted in the phys.org report, scientists have measurements for 11 Milky Way satellite galaxies, 8 of which are orbiting in a tight disk perpendicular to the spiral galaxy's plane. There are probably other satellites in the system that can't be seen from Earth because they're blocked by the Milky Way's dusty disk. An earlier study also found that out of the nearby Andromeda galaxy's 27 dwarf satellites, 15 show the same impossible alignment. A lead author of the study said of the new findings, "There should be pure chaos and not order. To find everywhere we look this extreme order where we expect disorder, this is strange." Study co-author Marcel Pawlowski stated, "This means that we are missing something. Either the simulations lack some important ingredient, or the underlying model is wrong. This research may be seen as support for looking into alternative models." Such alternative models offered by the electric universe and plasma cosmology can no longer be ignored by institutional science. In the electric universe, Birkeland current filaments pervade all of space, traveling from the sun to the Earth to power the auroras, flowing through molecular clouds and electromagnetically pinching material to form stars, and even organizing material over the vastest cosmic distances to form galaxies. In this view, space has a substructure of twisted pair current filaments, with stars and galaxies forming along them like pearls on a string. In a forthcoming episode, retired professor of electrical engineering Dr. Donald Scott will explain why cosmic-scale Birkeland currents may indeed eliminate the perceived need for dark matter. In a scientific paper published in 2015, Dr. Scott offered his original modeling of a Birkeland current structure, identified visually as counter-rotating cylinders, as seen in the earthly auroras, and at the poles of the gas giants Saturn and Jupiter, respectively. Scheduled for publication in April of this year in the journal Progress in Physics, Dr. Scott's paper, Birkeland Currents in Dark Matter, explores the Birkeland current as an explanation for the mysterious stellar velocity profiles within galaxies. As seen in this graph, the predicted stellar velocities based on Dr. Scott's model and the actual stellar velocities measured over nearly a century compare remarkably well. In this brief clip of his forthcoming presentation, Dr. Scott explains as follows.
The velocity in these stars, really, in the real world, and they've been measured like this for 85 years now, they vary as the square root of r. The last picture is a comparison of the predicted and actual stellar velocity. So if you take my model of the Birkeland current and assume that it's feeding the rotation in the Birkeland current is responsible for the rotation of the galaxy, that is the comparison between the actual velocity, which is that sort of wiggly, sort of a very lazy S curve, and the square root of r is the smoother curve there. And that's exactly what my Birkeland current model predicts should happen. So there's no surprises. And these guys have been chasing their tails down a box canyon for 85 years now, looking and crying out that they know that dark matter exists, but they can't find it. That's because there's no reason for it.
For Dr. Scott's full interview and for ongoing analysis of these scientific developments, stay tuned to Space News from the Electric Universe.